Hello, everyone. Welcome back. I am Mr. Cobalt, Mr. Dean Cobalt, and today I am going to be talking about significant figures with a mixed operations, meaning what do you do when you have a problem that has multiplication and division with adding and subtracting? How do you figure out the number of digits to keep from your calculator? And so I'm going to go over a few problems. And I'll explain what to do during the problems. So, example number one. So here you can see that you have to multiply these numbers, but then you have this in parentheses that you are going to subtract and then multiply. So when you're doing these sorts of calculations, you're gonna have to follow the order of operations. But a lot of times, you're doing calculations step by step in a word problem anyway. So you're going to have to do one calculation first, and then you're going to have to take that answer and follow to another calculation. So maybe you need to multiply and divide, and then maybe you need to subtract that from something. Or maybe you need to subtract two values before you multiply it with another value. So that's where this is going to come in. Regarding significant figures, because when you get that final answer, you need to figure out how many digits to keep from your calculator. So for example, you can put all of this into your calculator and it'll spit out this answer here, but then you have to figure out, okay, well, how many digits do I keep? Because I multiplied and divided, and we learned from the last couple of videos that each of those has different rules. Remember that adding, subtracting, the rule is the answer should have the least number of decimal places. But for multiplication and division, the rule is that your answer should have the least number of significant figures. So which is it? Well, it's a combination of both. So what we have to do here is first you need to do what's in the parentheses first. So here we need to subtract first. So when we subtract these two measures, we get this answer here. And so here, because we had subtracted, we need to use the rule regarding the number of decimal places. So the least number of decimal places is going to apply at this point here. So to figure out how many decimal places I'm allowed to keep for my answer, I need to go back to these two here. And it's the least number of decimal places. So I have three decimal places here, and I have two decimal places there. So that means that since two is the least number, or the lesser of the two, then that means that I can only keep the four and the seven. I can only go up to the seven. So I don't really want to keep the 9. However, in this case, I don't want to drop the 9 right now. So I don't want to do any dropping or rounding before I get to my final answer. Otherwise, I will end up with a calculator error or rounding error, and I don't want a rounding error. So I'm going to keep all the digits. And the rule of thumb is you want to at least keep one digit after the last one you're allowed to have to avoid those rounding errors. But you can keep as many digits as you want after it. You know, it's up to you. But one should be enough. We only have one after. So to keep myself from forgetting that 7 is the last digit, I underline it. So the 7 is the last one that matters or counts as far as sig figs or significant digits or significant figures. So now that I have this done and I know what my last significant digit is for this measure, now I'm going to multiply. And so now that I'm multiplying, I'm using the rule regarding significant figures. So I'm going to figure out what the sig figs are. So this has three sig figs. This 0 is significant because it's between two non-zero numbers. So that's significant. So I have 4 significant figures. And then here's where the underlying comes in. if I don't have this underlined, I can forget, and then I might inadvertently say, oh, I have three sig figs here, when in fact I only have two. So I'm only allowed to consider up to the seven. I can't go past the seven when I'm thinking of how many sig figs I have. So this would actually be two sig figs. So I have two sig figs. The least number is two, so that means I only am allowed two sig figs. So I keep the 19. And so the answer that I am going to report is 19 inches cubed. So that's how that works. The thing you gotta keep in mind also is whenever you're adding and subtracting, the number of significant figures can change in your answer. So you can start with certain measurements with a certain number of significant figures. You could do all your calculations and get to the end from your calculator. And then you got to figure out from that number you got from your calculator how many digits to keep. But if you finished with a multiplication, then you can't really figure it out if you're going back to the original problems, because if you had to add and subtract along the way, that can change the number of significant figures from what you began with. So you can't just go back to all your original numbers and look at which one had the least number of sig figs. So you got to watch out for that. And this is a good example of that. So in this example, I'm going to do the subtraction first. So with the subtraction, I'm looking at decimal places. So I got three decimal places there. I have three decimal places there. So the least number is three. I do my subtraction and I get 0.003. So I have my three decimal places. So that's good. And you'll notice that the number of sig figs has changed. So I have four significant figures here. I have three significant figures here. But now here I only have one significant figure, because these zeros are at the front of your number and they are not significant. They are never significant. So now that I have this number done, so now I can divide, and now I'm looking at significant figures. And so this has four sig figs and this has one. So my answer can only have one sig fig. So the answer here is going to end up having one sig fig. So that's the seven. This is a nine. I round this up to eight. So it's going to be 8 × 10⁴ grams per milliliter. So that's what I would report as my answer. The third example, again, we have multiplication and division, and in the parentheses I have subtraction. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to subtract in the parentheses. And again, when I'm subtracting, I'm looking at least number of decimal places. So I'm going to do this first. So in this operation, I'm looking at decimal places. I get this answer and I have to figure out, okay, well, how many digits am I allowed to keep? So I look at decimal places. I have four here and I have two here. So that means that this answer, I can only keep up to the second decimal place. So, but I want to keep, again, I'm not done with the rest of my calculations. So I want to keep this, so I don't get a rounding error. And so I'm going to underline the four to remind me that that four is the last significant digit. So now I'm going to continue with the calculation. So I multiply these together, I divide by that, and then I get this answer on my calculator. And so now I have to figure out, okay, well, how many sig figs can I keep? So now I'm looking at the least number of sig figs. So this has four. And this has six. And now again, I have to be careful, because if I don't have this underlined, I can think about, oh, that's 4, and the least number would be 4, and I would get it wrong. So that's why I underlined this to help me remember that that 4 is the last significant figure in this number. So this actually has 2 significant figures, so that's 2. So that means that I can only keep 2 significant figures. So I'm going to cut it off after the 2. There's a 7 there, so I'm going to round that to 53. So that means I have 53 inches. So that would be the number that I would report in this third problem. And then finally, for the fourth example, in this case, I have the multiplication in parentheses, so I'm going to do that first. So I'm going to do the parentheses, I'm going to do the multiplication, and then when I'm done with that, I'm going to subtract 8.02. So again, I am multiplying, so I'm looking at the least number of significant figures. So I'm going to figure out which one has the least number of sig figs. So this has 14. This has 14.854, so that's 4 sig figs. This has 0.55. That 0 is not significant, so I have 2 there. Again, zeros at the beginning of your number, the leading zeros are never significant, so you don't ever have to worry about leading zeros. So the least number is 2 sig figs, so my answer that I get from here is 8.162, so I'm only allowed to keep 2 of those sig figs. So I have the 8 and the 1. So the 8 and the 1, the 1 is the last one. So I underline that. And that, so that tells me that I can only, as far as significance goes, I can only go up to the 1. But I'm going to keep everything. I'm going to subtract 8.02 from this. And because I'm doing subtraction, I'm now looking at decimal places. So the least number of decimal places. So here's my answer after I subtract. So now I have to figure out, well, what can I keep? Well, now I have to look at decimal places. So here, remember, that is the last significant digit. So I can't count past there. So this only has 1 decimal place, and this has 2 decimal places. So 1 is less than 2. So I am only allowed to have 1 decimal place in my answer. So I would report 0.1 inches squared for my final answer. And that's how you figure these problems out. So whenever you have a mixed a problem where you're mixing up operations, where you have to, in your first step, you have to multiply and divide, and then you got to take that answer and subtract or add. Or maybe you have to add and subtract first at one point, and then you got to carry that answer and you got to divide or multiply by another answer. That's where this is going to come in handy. Because each time you do an operation, you got to keep in mind that how many sig figs or how many decimal places you're allowed to keep in that particular answer. Now, if you need to use that answer in a further calculation, keep the digits that you got on your calculator, or at least one. You need to keep at least one extra digit past the one you're allowed, the last one you're allowed to have, and then continue the operation. And then, but you gotta keep that in mind when you, in the end of the problem, when you're trying to figure out the number of digits to keep in your final answer. So this is what you need to do. Okay. I hope that made a lot of sense. I hope that was helpful. If you like this video, please like the video, subscribe to the video, share the video, make a comment in the comment section, ask a question if you have anything you want me to go over. So thank you very much for joining me, and see you next time.